So we use a combination of things. Over my career, I've used lots of different things, all the way from eye tracking to usability to quantitative analysis. But I think the most important thing is to be iterative and to be in a process of learning. The worst case scenario you can get to is what I call the sort of culture of delivery, which is your whole processes are aligned to one ship date and we redesign checkout. Okay, what's the next project? We shipped that. That's done. Right? That's a culture of delivery. A culture of learning is, hey, we're going to try this. Oh, let's see what we can learn before we actually build it. Oh, we started to build it. Let's prototype it and make it better and better. Hey, we launched it. What happened? Let's measure. We should tweak that. Let's keep measuring. Let's keep learning. When you do that, then you find all of these opportunities for optimization and for insights that you wouldn't have if all you're doing is getting to that launch and then moving on to the next launch after that. So internally here, I have a number of different teams that look at both sides of the equation. We do rapid iterative prototyping up front. So we'll build a little prototype, we'll put users through it, and we'll learn, do they understand our intent? Can they actually act on what we're trying to allow them to do? And then after launch, we'll go and track the metrics. And sometimes with the metrics, you'll see, oh, that's weird. Why is that going on? And the next natural step is to actually go talk to people. There's a case study that Expedia published a long time ago, which was fascinating to me because they had a checkout flow, standard thing, right? You have booked the trip, and you're going through it, and they had this optional field called company right above billing information. And for whatever reason, people would enter their company and then start putting in the address of their company below company, which kind of makes sense, right? But what happened is they would get these billing errors because they put in a billing address that is not the billing address of their credit card. Instead, it's their company that they worked for. And this was an optional field. So Expedia removed it, and instantly they got $12 million more in profit a year overnight just from dropping this one optional field. And until you actually see somebody go through the flow, how would you ever guess why there's so many errors? You'd have to talk to a couple people like, oh, they think it's their company's address. That's why we're getting all these billing errors. It's not like bad credit cards or what have you. So that combination of the quantitative data, lots of errors in billing addresses, and qualitative, why? Let's talk to them, really lets you fix the product and make it work.